Hello friends, here I am Kiranjit Garg. Today we discuss the chapter 4 of legal. This is basically part 1 of the chapter 4. Chapter 4 is related to returns, inspection and winding up. Inspection basically of balance sheet and winding up basically of banking company. And the returns, all the returns relating to the banking company, which we have to discuss in this lecture. Basically, chapter 4 is little bit lengthy and important as it covers most of the important questions. So we discuss this chapter 4 in 4 parts. Part 1, 2, 3, 4. Each part 15 to 20 minutes. After each part, we have discussed also one MCQ lecture, which are a separate playlist. So let's start with the today's lecture. First of all, I am Kiranjit Garg from UGEM Shiksha Kendra. Our Facebook page is Aim to Achieve, and our Telegram group is JAIIB JAB UGEM. All lectures updates and notes are available in our group. If you like our lecture, please subscribe our channel and like the video, because only when you like the video we know that you appreciate the video or not. And for all lecture notes, which are handwritten notes, basically for handwritten notes you have to mail on our email ID. Notes are very helpful for you. Notes cover important points, previous year questions and all other latest questions cover in our notes. So let's start the chapter. Basically, as the heading of the chapter says that returns, inspections and winding up. So what is the main function? Basically, when the year is ended, financial year, like March 31st, 2020, so bank has to submit its balance sheet. So what is the proper process? First of all, prepare balance sheet annually. And after that, this balance sheet is audited by duly qualified auditors. So balance sheet is audited by qualified auditors. And after that, when the balance sheet is audited by auditors, then we have to submit it to the RBI and registrar of companies. After the audited by auditors, then it is submitted to the RBI and registrar of companies. This is the whole process with respect to the balance sheet. So let's start annual accounts and balance sheet. There are some important points regarding that which we have discussed point by point. First of all, as per section 29, here we discuss only main points, and for detail or for all the points you have to follow our notes. Section 29 of the Banking Regulation Act states that every bank has to prepare balance sheet. Every banking company has to prepare balance sheet and profit and loss account. As per section 29 of the Banking Regulation Act, every bank has to prepare balance sheet and profit and loss account at the end of each calendar year. On expiry of 12 months. Basically, calendar year is 12 months. This policy is also for foreign banks. For foreign banks has to cover their entire business operating in India. Basically, they have to cover their entire business operating in India in balance sheet. सेकेंड पॉइंट इज बैलेंस शीट एंड प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट. बेसिकली बैंक्स हैव टू मेंटेन बैलेंस शीट एंड प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट्स. मस्ट बी साइंड बाय एटलीस्ट थ्री डायरेक्टर्स. मस्ट बी साइंड बाय एटलीस्ट थ्री डायरेक्टर्स ऑफ द कंपनी. मस्ट बी साइंड बाय एटलीस्ट थ्री डायरेक्टर्स ऑफ द कंपनी और बाय द मैनेजर और द प्रिंसिपल ऑफिसर. आफ्टर दैट थर्ड पॉइंट इज बैलेंस शीट. बेसिकली दे हैव प्रॉपर फॉर्मेट एंड प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट आर टू बी प्रिपेयर्ड इन द फॉर्म सेट आउट इन द थर्ड शेड्यूल. बेसिकली इन द थर्ड शेड्यूल ऑफ बैंकिंग रेगुलेशन एक्ट. दिस एक्ट स्टेट दैट हाउ टू प्रिपेयर द बैलेंस शीट एंड प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट थर्ड शेड्यूल ऑफ द बैंकिंग रेगुलेशन एक्ट और एज बेसिकली और एज पार्ट वन और एज पार्ट वन शेड्यूल फोर और एज पार्ट वन शेड्यूल फोर ऑफ द कंपनीज एक्ट. आइदर थर्ड शेड्यूल ऑफ बैंकिंग रेगुलेशन एक्ट और पार्ट वन ऑफ शेड्यूल फोर ऑफ द कंपनीज रेगुलेशन एक्ट स्टेट्स दैट द हाउ टू प्रिपेयर द बैलेंस शीट एंड प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट. फोर्थ पॉइंट इज बेसिकली आफ्टर प्रिपेयरिंग एंड ऑडिटिंग publication of so that public aware what the company's financial condition. Publication of balance sheet and profit and loss account in a newspaper. Basically balance sheet and profit and loss account in a newspaper within 6 months from the end of the period. Basically 6 months from the end of the calendar year. After that, every banking company has to submit 3 copies of balance sheet and profit and loss account. Every banking company has to submit 3 copies of balance sheet and profit and loss account to RBI within, here 6 months, publication is within 6 months and submission of copies of balance sheet and profit and loss account to RBI within 3 months from the end of the period. Within 3 months from the end of the period. So after that, furnishing of accounts and balance sheet to registrar, basically to registrar of companies. So as under section 220 of Companies Act, basically 220 of Companies Act provides submission of balance sheet and profit and loss account to registrar of companies. Under section 220 of the Companies Act. And after that, in basically this is for the companies, not banking companies, for the companies. And for banking companies, specific banking companies, section 32 of Banking Regulation Act provide submission of 3 copies to 3 copies of accounts to registrar. 3 copies of accounts to registrar. And further section 31 for this for banking companies of BR Act provides submission to RBI. Basically section 32 to registrar, section 31 to RBI of what three copies of balance sheet and auditor report. Balance sheet and auditor report. Our further one point is, if any company wants to submit additional information, basically if any company want to submit additional information regarding to balance sheet and profit and loss account to RBI, basically to whom? To RBI, additional information to RBI, then under which section? Section 27(2) of the BR Act. Then they can submit that information to the RBI under Section 27(2) of the BR Act. This question asked in the previous year exam in 2018. As per basically memory based questions from student, this question is asked in 2018. Additional, basically additional information to RBI regarding the profit and loss account and the balance sheet under Section 27(2) of the Banking Regulation Act. And after that, display of balance sheet and accounts. Basically, foreign banks, Indian banks has to publish in the newspaper. Foreign banks have to display their balance sheet and profit and loss accounts in a conspicuous place. Basically, this is that place which is visible to everyone, like on their website or any notice board. And after that, one more point, and this has to be done not later than This has to be done not later than first Monday. This has to be done not later than first Monday in August. Not later than first Monday in August of any year. Not later than first Monday in August in any year in which it carries its business. Carries its business. Basically, the year in which it carries its business, they have to publish it not later than first Monday in the August. After that, this is important also, audit and auditors. Basically, first of all, banking company has to prepare the balance sheet, and after auditing by the auditors, they have to submit to the RBI and the registrar of companies. Then under which section? Basically, this is the provision. Basically, under Section 30 of the Banking Regulation Act, balance sheet and profit and loss account of a banking company, balance sheet under Section 30 of the Banking Regulation Act, balance sheet and profit and loss account of the banking company have to be audited. Basically, under which section? 30 of the Banking Regulation Act, both balance sheet and profit and loss account of a banking company has to be audited. Then what are the power and functions of auditor? There are some powers and functions of the auditor. So let's hear. Basically, all powers and functions and duty of auditors and the liabilities and penalties to which they are subjected under, basically all powers, function, duties and liabilities, basically all are under Section 227 of the Companies Act. Basically, all these are mentioned under Section 227 of the Companies Act, and all these provisions are applicable to banking companies also. Basically, the provisions under Section 227 of the Companies Act, these provisions are also applicable to the banking companies also. Basically, this section defines the powers, function, duties and liabilities of the auditor. So what are these duties or functions? First of all, in dealing with bank accounts, the responsibility of the auditor, is not confined to safeguard the interest of the proprietors. Basically, is not confined to safeguard the interest of the proprietors. Basically, this means that auditors does not have confined to safeguard. Basically, if there is any error regarding any property or there is any illegal work regarding any property, they have to mention that. They have to mention that that work in the report, in his report. Basically, this is the meaning of that. And after that, after the auditing, when the auditor do the auditing, the auditor will be responsible, basically, or the auditor will be reasonably blamed. Mainly, the auditor will be reasonably blamed if after signing the auditor reports on an apparently sound balance sheet, the bank is afterwards found insolvent. Basically, this means that when the auditor audits the balance sheet report and it sounds balance, basically balance sheet sounds balance, and after that, after some time, banks becomes insolvent, this means that balance sheet is not correct. Basically, there is some fault or there is some mismatch in the balance sheet. So who is responsible for that? Auditor is responsible for that because he signed the incorrect balance sheet. So this is the meaning. So under section 227 of the Companies Act, these provisions are mentioned. And one more thing, special audit. This also comes, the question regarding special audit, basically under which section special audit is mentioned. Basically, audit is mentioned under section 30 and special audit is mentioned under section 31. 31 of the Banking Regulation Act, or specify we can say that 31B of the Banking Regulation Act, special audit is mentioned. Banking Regulation Act 1949. When the special audit is, basically when RBI or the central government wants to audit any banking company due to some specific reason, then special audit is done. Or this audit is done in the interest of the public, basically for the benefit of public or depositors. One more point regarding that, the expenses, who can bear the expenses of special audit? Basically, the expenses in relation to the special audit has to be borne by the banking company. So the expenses of the special audit is to be borne by the banking company, and this is mentioned under section 31B of the Banking Regulation Act. So in this lecture we have discussed regarding balance sheet and auditor's powers and special audit. In the next lecture we have to discuss regarding returns, basically seven types of return, when they have to submit it, and one more topic in the part two, basically returns and preservation of records. Basically, banks have to preserve records under prevention money, basically Money Laundering Act. So how much time the banks have to preserve the records, and they have given back the records to the customer or to the government organization or not, all these we have to discuss in the part 2 of chapter 4. So if you like our video, then please share with your friends, and in the comment section you can give your review, and please like the video. Thank you.